Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Colleagues.
An unprecedented expansion of ASEAN-US cooperation. It could not have happened without Indonesia's support. We look forward to discussing all of the work that we're doing to improve the lives of our combined 1 billion people. As we take stock of this affirmative agenda, we also have to work together to address challenges to the shared vision, whether it's Russia's illegal invasion of Ukraine, the DPRK's nuclear weapons and ballistic missile programs, the ongoing and heartbreaking crisis in Burma, or the PRC's escalatory and unlawful actions taken against the Philippines in the South China Sea over the last few months, the United States and ASEAN, and address the most pressing issues of our time. On that, we are pleased to take note of the successful resupply today, the second Thomas Shoal, which is the product of an agreement reached between the Philippines and China. We applaud that and hope and expect to see that it continues going forward. Allow me a moment of personal privilege, our own ambassador, Ambassador Abraham, for his efforts.
Colleagues, while we enjoy the ASEAN-US good relation, our partnership should also contribute to global peace and stability. We should be the guardian of the international laws in a consistent manner. When we talk about respecting international law, it should be applied to all. It should be applied in Ukraine issue, South China Sea, and certainly for Palestine. In Palestine, for example, we cannot continue closing our eyes to see the dire humanitarian situation in Gaza. As we speak now, almost 40,000 people have died. We need a ceasefire. We need a sustainable peace to stop this human suffering.
For all the hard work and support of our growing partnership. Finally, I'd like to thank the crisis in Gaza is having on so many people around the world, but first and foremost on the